67% of our youth that are homeless are living in emergency shelters. Now, this is over the course of an entire year. Emergency shelters or transitional living programs. 47% of them are doubled up with friends, with open couches. 23% are outside, unfortunately, sometimes in weather like this.
As you just heard, in temperatures like we're facing now, homelessness can be a life and death situation. Most people wouldn't picture the teenagers who go to their children's school or the ones who wait on you when you go out to eat as the ones facing such a dangerous circumstance. But experts tell Valley News Team's Veronica Marshall, those are the faces of some of our most vulnerable community members.
A lot of our youth that come through are working. And if they're not working, they're actively looking for work so they can be working. And they might be your server. They might be the person that checks you out at Hornbacher's or at Target or Walmart.
Experts say homelessness carries a stigma with it where people often blame the victim.
You think that person's lazy. You think that person hasn't put in their time, hasn't, you know, worked hard. It can happen to anybody.
But for teens living on the streets, their situation is usually a lot more complicated.
Some have left home, sometimes because of family difficulties. If you come from a background where there's a lot of drug use, or where we've had some individuals whose parents aren't in agreement with their sexual orientation. And they find that they're in a very uncomfortable and unsafe living environment. It's safer to conceive of living on the streets.
Job loss or other unexpected financial obstacles can also leave teenagers without stable housing. But advocates say getting everyone into a warm bed is critical, especially now.
It is personally important to me that we're able to, make sure that everybody has that safe place to stay in. Plus a colder, a cold climate state like Minnesota, especially in December, it's a very important issue.
And local groups have a plan.
We're also looking at moving into emergency shelter hours because the weather has dropped, the temperatures dropped significantly. We're hopefully within the next week or so going to have some emergency spaces opened up so we can get some youth off the streets.
In Fargo, Veronica Marshall, Valley News Live.
Advocates say if homeless teenagers get the help they need now, they'll have the skills they need to succeed.